So in this video, I'll be showing you how to use cframe.lookat in Roblox Studio. And this is a very powerful function that allows you to do some really crazy stuff with C-frames using a very simple concept. So make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoy the video, but without further ado, let's get into it. So I'm going to start by creating two parts, just so we can work with some parts. It's easier to visualize than arbitrary points in space. So with our two parts, I'm going to take the bottom one. We're going to make sure both of them are anchored, first of all. And I'm going to take the bottom one, just rename it to look part. And then in order to see where the faces of this part are, because that's really good when debugging with C-frames, I'm going to add a surface selection. You could use a decal, you could use a surface GUI, but this is just for the purposes of looking at where the faces are. It's only for debugging. So I'm going to set the Adorni to look part, face to front, duplicate that. We're going to have one for the front and then one for the top. We're going to change the color to green. There we go. So I'm going to go into my look part and create a script. Zoom in a little bit. Just for ease of use, I'm going to define our part or look part. It should be equal to script.parent and then our part, which is going to be our target part, but I'll just leave it as part. We're going to say workspace, if I can spell that right. We're just going to use autocomplete, workspace.part. There we go. So first demonstration, we're going to make our bottom part, look at our top part. So we're going to set our look part.cframe equal to cframe.lookat look part.position, then part.position. So what this is basically doing is, if you've been coding on Roblox for a while, this looks kind of familiar, because there used to be a cframe constructor, cframe.new, that took in a like starting position and a look at vector. But they've converted this into a new function. Temporarily, they had cframe from matrix sort of holding that role with like a little function that you can make. But cframe look at basically takes in two parameters. We're looking at the two parameter. I'll go into the three parameter version a little bit later. It takes the position that we're starting at and the position we want to look at. It's that simple. So all you do is you're taking this look part position and we want it to look at the part dot position. So if we were to run this, you can see the blue face, which is denoting our front face, is facing upwards, looking at our other part. And this works if we move it. So if I say move this out this way, it points exactly to where that part is. And it doesn't matter how far away it is. I can drag it all the way down here. It looks at it. And that's really, really, really cool. And the real benefit of this is it just allows you to make your stuff very, very like simple and very robust. So you can do like another example. What if I just want to rotate the part, but I don't want to deal with angles? You could just say look part.cframe to, or point to object space, or to world space, I should say. And then we'll say vector3.new. Let's just do a point in front of it. So it'll be 0, 0, negative 10. Actually, let's do 0, 5, negative 10. So if you don't know what point to world space or like object space and world space is, make sure to check out my video on that. I will link it right now. But what this will basically do is it'll take our position and it'll make it point towards a position that's 10 studs up front and 5 studs up of our part. So if you run this, you can see it's pointing at like an arbitrary point in space. So instead of, say, rotating this like 45 degrees, you could do something like this just to make it a little, makes a little more sense since it's pointing at it. So for right now, we've only been using cframe look at with two arguments, but there is an optional overload. Let me just show you down here. cframe.lookat, And you see there's a little 1 out of 2. We can go to the second one. And we have the at, the target, and the up vector. So what this means is we can specify our point that we're starting at, the point that we want to look at, and then an optional up vector, which is basically saying what we want to look at relative to our part. So the only really good way I can explain this, only way I've ever used it, is on like a ship, for example, like a spaceship. So when you want your part to look at the player's mouse, you want the part to continually like rotate around a given point. So actually, let me get rid of this. So let me take our part here. So without specifying anything in your like look at, well, what happen is, like, let's say this is a spaceship. So let me get my rotate tools. Here we go. When you're doing like a loop, for example, you would go up. But once look at passes this central point, so it's facing up, right? Once it passes this central point, the part would completely flip. So let me get this. So it would like completely flip, and then it would go this way because it wants the top of this part to be facing upwards as much as possible. But that's stupid because we want our part to be inverted. So whenever you want to change the front face of the up vector, like the up vector of your part, like the top face relative to your point, you'd use the up vector. So an example of this is, obviously I'm not gonna like bring in a whole spaceship, whatever. I have a little simple script in server storage. I'm just gonna drag that in, and I'm gonna disable my old script. So here it is. Basically, what's happening here is, let me place my part correctly. So I want to have my part get placed above and behind this part, our look part. So what this script basically does is, let me get it up, here we go. What this script does is it basically takes, it has a while to do, and we start at a point 3 studs in front of our player, or in front of our look part, and then we lerp it, which basically means linear interpolate between. It's basically like a tween, except instead of it doing all at once, we have to manually call lerp each iteration of our loop. So we lerp it to the intended position by 0.1, which is the alpha value for the lerp. You don't have to understand this line, but the biggest difference is what will happen when we don't have an up vector. So let's, right now we're setting look part dot cframe equal to cframe dot look at the position and the look at vector that we're calculating up here. So for right now, ignore this. Just notice how there's only 2 parameters. So we run this. You can see that as the part rotates, it'll start like twisting. And that's not what we want. We want the top face to like loop around. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna set the up vector to our look part dot cframe dot up vector, so it does the transformation relative to our current up vector, so we'll get a little bit of a different result. And you can see the part is staying constantly tilting towards this part, and the front face is facing down. So honestly, that's probably not a good explanation of up vector, but whenever I've used it, I've just kind of like guessed around with it. I don't know all of the mechanics inside of it because C-frames are pretty simple, like matrices, but I haven't really gone into matrices in depth, so I don't really understand what I'm doing. But I sort of know how these work, and really that should be enough for Roblox because we're programming, we're not taking a test, so you can guess, you can fool around, you can experiment, and an up vector is just basically telling you where the top face should go relative to the rest of the part, and it helps orient your whole C frame. So that's about it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. This C frame look at is a very simple concept, but very powerful. It's very good for debugging, and for readability, it works wonders. It's so intuitive instead of using matrices or some other C-frame functions, and it's just really, really good. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and subscribe if you did. comment any questions down below, because this can get complex very quickly. But I encourage you to test this out for yourself. Just play around. That's the best way to learn, because you'll just get develop an intuition and you'll be able to figure out what to do and when to do it. But other than that, I hope you guys have a nice day and goodbye.